Hello everyone, today we'll be solving a question using DAX. So you have a table called sales, and you have three columns called order date, ship date and amount. And if you see the order date, so the order is placed on Jan 1st till Jan 5th. These are the order, the dates when customer raised an order, and these are the dates when the customer when the order is shipped. So this is the output you require. You require a date column, and you need the total sales by order date, and you need the total sales by ship date. So hope you understood the question. So this is easy to solve using SQL, but the question is to use to solve it using DAX. So before we go to the Power BI and see how to solve this, if you're watching this channel for the first time, please click on the like button and also click on subscribe button for more videos. So now let's go back to Power BI and see how to solve this. So as shown earlier, we already have the sales table. So we have this order date, ship date and amount. So this is the data. So order date and ship date and the amount. And also to we have also created one more table. We have already have one more table called calendar. So this contains all the amounts. This contains all the dates from January 1st till January 10th. So now, what we need to do to achieve the required output, that is total sales by order date and total sales by ship date. First, what we'll do, we need to establish a relationship between the sales table and the calendar table. So first, what I'll do, I'll establish a relation between date and the order date. So if you see the calendar date and order date, I will establish a one-to-many relationship, and cross filter direction I'll keep single, because I want my calendar table to slice the size to slice the sales table, but I do not want the reverse. So just a single direction should be sufficient, and I will create this. So the relationship is created. Now I'll go back to the report view, and I'll create the measure total sales by order date. Total sales by order date. So now it is simple sum of sales of amount, okay, and simple sum of sales by sales of amount is the measure definition. So now what I'll do, I'll use this, you'll create a table with all the required dates, and with all the required dates I'll just use this measure total sales by order date. So if you see Jan 1st, Jan 2nd, Jan 3rd, Jan 4th, Jan 5th, these are the total sales by order date. So now here comes the interesting question, total sales by ship date. And if you are aware, between two tables you can have only one active relationship. So you cannot have multiple relationships between two tables. If you want multiple relationships between two tables, you can create it, but you have to keep that relationship as inactive. So if you double click this, you see this, make this relationship active. This particular checkbox is ticked, so that means this is an active relationship. So now what I'll do, I'll create one more relationship between date and ship date column. And again, I want my calendar table to slice the sales table, but I do not want my sales table to slice the calendar table. So I'll keep it. So I'll just make it one to many, and I'll keep it single direction. And I cannot make this relationship active. So if I make this relationship active, you'll get an error saying ambiguous paths, because as per the rule, you need to have only a single relationship between two tables. So to remove that, what we have to do, I'll make this relationship inactive, and I'll click on save. So if you see, whenever you see this dotted lines in the relationship mentioned, that means it is a inactive relationship. Okay, so now I'll go back and I'll create one more measure called total sales by ship date, shipping date. Total sales by shipping date. So here what I'll do, I'll simply do calculate sum of sales amount. And here, since if we do this sum of sales amount, and if I use the calendar column, since the relationship is on the order date, you'll not get the amount, you'll not get the required amount based on shipping date. So for this particular measure, I want to use the shipping date column as the present in the sales table. So for that, I have to use this use relationship. Use relationship is a function which will activate the inactive relationship, and it will inactivate and it will deactivate the existing relationship for that particular measure execution. So for the user relationship, if you see the use relationship, you have two arguments, column name 1 and column name 2. Column name 1 and column name 2 are nothing but the two columns between the two tables in which the inactive relationship is established. So we have created a relationship between sales of ship date and calendar of date. And if I use this, the measure is created, and I will simply use this measure here. So if you see here, for timing to validate, we'll keep this side by side. Okay, so this is the input table. Jan 1st you have 100, Jan 2nd you have 150, 200, 250 and 300. So yeah, as per the order date, on Jan 1st you have 100, Jan 2nd 150, 3rd 200, 4th 250 and 5th 300. But again, for shipping date, you do not have you do not have data between Jan 5th. So that's why before Jan 5th, the shipping total sales by shipping date is blank. So from 5th to 9th, you have this amount. So that's why from 5th to 9th, you see this data. So if you want to replace these nulls with zero, you can do, but I will not suggest you to do. So we keep this in a variable where a is equal to, and we'll use the return statement, return if e is blank of a comma 0 comma a. That means if this particular value, if it's blank, then it will return 0. If it is not blank, it will return whatever this particular value is. So now if I click this, you'll see zeros, and you'll see a lot of zeros because these all dates are there, and this is not required. Only till that's why you have to always keep blank. Okay, so this is the simple solution. So this can be achieved using a use relationship. So you can create n number of relationships between two tables, but you have to keep only one active relationship. Say suppose instead of order date and ship date, there might be one more column. Payment date. Maybe you ordered on today, but you made the payment tomorrow, and shipping date is something else. If you want to add a payment date, you can still establish a relationship between payment date. You can establish an inactive relationship, and if you want to show this amount by total sales by payment date, then again the same way you have to use the use relationship again. Okay, so hope you all understood the question and also the solution. So if you like this content, please click on the like button and also click on subscribe button for more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.